Ever wished your Excel spreadsheets could surprise you with a twist of randomness? Today I'm about to show you a simple trick that turns your ordinary Excel sheet into a powerful random number generator, perfect for simulations, games, or even spicing up your data analysis. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. All right, here's what we're going to do today. I'm going to walk you through three powerful Excel functions that generate random numbers. Rand, RANDBETWEEN, and RANDARRAY. I'll show you step-by-step how to use each of these functions, plus a quick trick on how to freeze your random numbers so they don't change with every recalculation. Let's get started. Let's start with RAND. So I'm gonna go put my equal sign in for the function and start typing RAND. Here it is right here, and these are the three that we're gonna be working with. So with RAND, if I go ahead and just close the brackets like this and hit enter, I'm gonna get a random decimal. So when you're working with the RAND function, you're gonna get a decimal back. If I go and copy this down to a cell, it can be easily moved and I'll get another random decimal number. But notice each time I copy like this, all the numbers change. So even the ones that started with, and this is the trick I'll show you later on, how you can make sure you save those random numbers that they don't change if you recalculate one thing. So now the next thing what I want to show you is that we can do some customization to this RAND. So if I go back and let's say I wanted it to be between 0 and 100. So if I use the RAND here again, close my bracket, I'm just going to multiply by 100. So if I multiply by 100, you're going to see now that as I go through, all of these ones here will be all between 0 and 100. And again, notice every time I recalculate, these ones are recalculating up here as well. Now, the last one that I want to show you, you can do a customization with this RAND too. So let's say if I wanted it be between the numbers 5 and 25. So I go back to my, got to put my equal sign in, go back to my RAND, and same thing, close the bracket. I'm going to multiply this time. And so I said 5 to 25. So what I'm going to do is go 25 minus 5, like this. But I'm not done yet. I have to add 5 as well. So if I add 5 like this, so the numbers are going to be between 5 and 25, but put plus 5 at the end. If I had it between 10 and 50, then I would be 50 minus 10, and a 10 would be here. So I'm going to go and hit enter, and you'll notice now each of these, when I copy them through, will all be between 5 and 25. So if you need some decimals, some random numbers to fill something out with decimals, that's how you can manipulate this function. Let's move on to RANDBETWEEN. If you want to randomly generate whole numbers, this is how you do it. You're going to be wanting to use the RANDBETWEEN function. So if I go and type in my equal sign and I'll start typing RAND, the RANDBETWEEN is right here. There's only two different arguments that I need to pick in here, and it's going to be the bottom and the top number. So if I put 4 as the bottom number, comma, and we'll say 45 as the top numbers, and then it'll be generated from 4 to 45. So if I hit enter, I get 36. I can copy these down just like before. So I can just copy them over row by row, but notice they're changing all the time. So I want to give you that tip that I was talking about. How do I stop them from changing if I have these set of random numbers that I need and I don't want them to change anymore? So what I can do is if I go ahead and highlight these, I'm going to go and use the shortcuts. I'm going to go Control C on my keyboard. And I want to show you if I go Control V, and notice that this is 4 and 11. If I just go Control V, it changed. Everything changed. So I'm just going to go back one step here. I just went Control Z. So how do I copy it with keeping the original numbers in the first place? So if I have these numbers here, so these are, it's 27, 43. If I go Control C, if I pick a spot now, if I go Control Shift V, now I keep these as 2743. This still changes over here, but these were the numbers that were randomly generated the first time, and they're not going to change at all anymore. The last random number generator I want to show you is the RANDARRAY function. And just to let you know, this is only available in Excel 2021 or 365. So if I go ahead and go to my RAND, and this time it's going to be a RANDARRAY, returns an array of random numbers. So as we go through, we can let it know how many rows you want, columns, min, max, integer. So we can pick decimal, whole numbers, or decimal in this. So if I go and say I want, let's say, 5 rows, and I put my comma in, I want to have, we'll go 4 or 6 columns, and they're going to be minimum will be 5, and the maximum will be 100. And then the integer, do we want it as a decimal or here you can see the difference here if we want a decimal. So I'm going to keep it as an integer, so it'll be true. I'm going to close this up and hit enter. There we go. So this is a great way to do this very quickly and hit choosing between decimal or the whole numbers there. So I hope you like this little trick about randomly generating numbers in Microsoft Excel. Let me know, have you used this before? You could use it in a few different fun ways, or I said, maybe you can even fill out some data here, some fake numbers if you need some. Thanks for watching this week on Teacher's Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.